Poynting Portable Antennas. Trying to keep it simple, but there's a lot of options and conversations these days about what can you use for IoT, for marine, for agriculture, or for vehicles and so forth. And at the moment, we are focusing on these three antennas that I have in front of me as the options for those kind of scenarios. But the key thing is, what can each of them bring and where are they actually most popular, mostly used? So on my left is an antenna that I've been talking about a lot in the past as well. It's the MIMO 3 series. I'm not going to go into the whole detail of what the whole series is. There's quite a few antennas in the range, but they all have the same form factor where it looks, I say it looks like a shoe, but it's kind of a shark fin on steroids, really. A big antenna that has the looks and feel of a shark and shark fin antenna. In essence, this antenna has a lot of variables, but it's 4G, 5G, it's Wi-Fi and GPS. The different families, the one that's most popular, the one that I have here is the MIMO 312, most popular for us because in the application, this is where you just have a good 4G antenna. You can put it on top of your roof, on your caravan, I mean, of a truck or any of those devices. That's where this would use. They are waterproof, so they can be used for marine as well, but it wasn't the original intent from what I can understand, or where we've really had a lot of interest in it. So the fact that it's waterproof just means you can really use it as well for your caravan. Put it on the van, put it on the vehicle, put it on the truck or anything, and you forget. There is a video that Poynting has done where they hit it with a big hammer to show how robust and rugged it is. So that can be used in that environment as well. The drawback that I have heard, and it's not a drawback, it's just a comment, that it's a bit high. So if you need a very low profile antenna, this is not the one that you would want to go for. The other options would be better for that. It is specifically designed for the lower frequency. So if you look at the spec sheets, I have it on with me. So in the 4G, 5G space, this antenna can work from 417 megahertz, 410 megahertz up to 3.8 gigahertz. So it covers all the 5G frequencies that we want to know. So look for the specific one for caravan, its trucks and so forth. Moving over to the right. So I'm just going to move over to the MIMO 4. So the MIMO 4 is one that sort of succeeded the MIMO 3 series, but this is still very valid because this performs much better in the low frequencies. The MIMO 4, which is like a buck form, but a bit bigger, performs much better in the higher frequencies. Now, where it gets applied is basically all the industries that I mentioned. So marine, it is waterproof. It can be used in marine, can be used in vehicles, can be used flat on a vehicle, but it also has the ability to be put on a mast. So it makes it very versatile. So if you have a setup where you actually have a pole going up, think about a home setup, can use a portable setup. You just want to quickly set up an antenna, as I have done in previous videos. This is a good antenna to use. There are quite a few of them out there, a few models. They start at 617 megahertz and they go up to 6 gigahertz on the 4G, 5G antenna. So they are fully capable of supporting any of the cellular bands that are out there in the world, not just here in Australia. The Wi-Fi is going to cover everything. So all the current and the future Wi-Fi bands are covered in the antennas that are in there. So it's 2.4 to 2.5 gigs. So that's the classic good Wi-Fi band. Plus the antennas also support 5 gigahertz up to 7.2 gigahertz, meaning any Wi-Fi band that is now or is still to come is supported in the antennas in the MIMO 4, also in the MIMO 3. So applications, mining, agriculture, marine, vehicles, trains, so forth, buses, that's all where this antenna would be usable. As you can see, it's much lower profile as the MIMO 3, so that's certainly something that you can consider between these two antennas. So MIMO 3, MIMO 4, but I'm purposely putting them out on the sides of the screen because I really want to talk now about the buck antenna. And that's going forward going to be the one that we're going to spend much more time talking about as well. I did do a similar video in the past, but there is now a version 2 out. And if you look on the Poynting website, they do say, as of today, the version 1 is end of life. The biggest difference is there is an O-ring at the end. So you could see if you look closely, there's an O-ring that is available to actually seal it a bit more. Antenna itself is still the same. So you could see it's quite a small, compact form factor. It supports all the bands that are mentioned in the MIMO 4 as well. So in terms of what technologies are covered, the PAC series covers GPS, as with all the antennas, 4G, 5G, as with all the other antennas. Not as low as this one, so it starts at 617 megahertz, goes up to 6 gig according to the specification. And the Wi-Fi bands that they support is also the 2.4 and the higher band, not just 5.8, but actually from 5 gig to 7.2 gig. So extremely versatile. I think the biggest application where this gets used the most is IoT or machine-to-machine type industry. So that's where this is really a massive antenna to be used. So you can imagine this small form factor on a, just put it there next to me, even a vending machine on a cash machine, something out in the middle of nowhere, this can be used on vehicle charge stations, so forth. Having this antenna on there is vandal resistant. I mean, nothing will actually make it look like you want to damage this. It's just a little thing that sticks out. It also comes with devices in the kit that allows you to put it on a mast so you can install it on various setups and so forth. What else can I say? It's extremely rugged. So if you think that is rugged, which I specifically think about the MIMO 3, which was hit by hammer, this thing is very compact. So it's waterproof, it's ultra rugged, so it can be used in really rough environments. Thinking about mining as well. So dirt, high vibration, anything. This is versatile, can be used, and it covers all the bands in the various types of antennas you have. That's really all I could say on this video. Now, we sell all these antennas. They often have, mostly have them in stock. If we don't have them in stock, just give us a call and we can get them in from Poynting Direct. The master box sizes means that we can get them in sets of 27 antennas, 3x3x3 in the box. So we can get bulk in for your projects. So if you have any projects need, just give us a call or visit our website, rfshop.com.au. On the next video, I will talk a bit more about the different families there is in the PAC antenna. See you soon. Cheers, bye-bye.